English Adventure, Book 5, Chapter 5, The Evergreen Guru. Let's get into our fun start. Do you have a favorite place where you like to spend your time? It may be a park, library, play zone, or a tree house. Write 3 sentences about your favorite place and why you love it. Now, compare what you have written with your partners. Do you both like the same places? Please compare and check. In a small town of Sundarpur, there was a lush, beautiful park known as Evergreen Grove. Despite its beauty, the park was often neglected. 4 friends, Sanjay, Priya, Vijay, and Meena, discovered the park during one of their summer vacations. They fell in love with the many colorful flowers and the rustling sound of the leaves in the wind. They started spending their afternoons in the park, playing and exploring many wonders of nature. One day, they noticed a small sapling struggling for life amidst the large trees. It was a tiny mango sapling, its leaves barely peeking out from the soil. "We should help this little one," said Priya, her voice filled with concern. Taking up the responsibility to take care of the sapling, the children started visiting the park every day. They watered the sapling, cleared all the weeds, and even built a small fence around it for protection. One day, while they were caring for the sapling, an elderly gentleman from the neighborhood, Mr. Sharma, saw them. He was a retired botanist and had spent his life studying plants. "You children are doing a commendable job," he said, smiling at their dedication. "But remember, a plant will thrive only if it is cared for without expecting anything in return." The children took Mr. Sharma's words to their heart. They were not looking for the tree to bear fruit. They genuinely cared for the little sapling and wanted it to grow. They continued nurturing it, and their bond with the sapling grew stronger with each passing day. Years passed, and the sapling grew into a tall, robust tree. It became the center of attraction in the Evergreen Grove, providing shade to visitors and a home for birds. However, despite its magnificent growth, the tree never bore any fruit. The residents of Sundarpur often ridiculed the children for their futile efforts. But the children were not deterred. They loved their tree whether it bore fruit or not. One bright spring morning, as the children were watering the tree, they noticed a golden hue near its trunk. On closer inspection, they were amazed to find a single golden mango hanging from one of the lower branches. The mango was not like any they had seen before. It shimmered in the sunlight and had a sweet, enchanting aroma. The news of the golden mango spread throughout Sundarpur. People from all around came to witness this extraordinary sight. The children were overjoyed. Their patience, love, and care had resulted in something truly magical. The golden mango was later auctioned at the town fair and it fetched a handsome price. The children decided to use the money for the betterment of the Evergreen Grove. They installed benches, built a small playground, and even set up a library in the park. The Evergreen Grove transformed into a vibrant community space where children played, adults relaxed, and everyone enjoyed the beauty of nature. Now, the moral of the story. When we do something out of love and not out of expectation, we often see the most valuable outcomes. And sometimes, nature rewards us in most unexpected way. Let's get into dictionary skills. The two words S-O-N, sun, and S-U-N, sun, are different, but we read them without any difference. We call them homophones. It's time for grammar adventures. Sometimes we talk about things that have not happened yet but will happen soon. This is called future tense. Example, I am going to buy a keyboard next week. I will read this book this evening.